success of our region, so a brief update on that. And obviously as well, the workhorse of our transport network, our bus services, lots that we can mention about the success of the bus alliance at this moment in time, but even more opportunely looking forward about how we'll be using some of the bulk powers that we're getting to have to take those services on to a new, better level of the city region. In terms of strategic rail issues, one of the city region's long-term priorities has always been about ensuring the city region is fully connected to high-speed rail, both north-south, but crucially, that west-east link connecting us with the rest of the north. We're working very, very closely with HS2 Transport for the North and others to achieve that vision. Our key focus at this moment in time is working with Transport for the North on a variety of route options to achieve that link from Liverpool, linking also with Warrington, and onto the HS2 network. And we're very much targeting September as the time when the HS2 hybrid bill phase 2B will be published, and our key target is getting passive provision for a Liverpool junction as part of that parliamentary bill process. So that's developing positively, and we'll keep people informed accordingly. Whilst high speed rail is vital for some of our longer distance connections and freeing up more capacity, particularly for freight and how we can deal with rail freight coming out of the port, obviously we also want to see some of the new capacity that can create use for local connectivity. One of our key focuses at the moment in time is about how we get much better links to our near neighbours in Wales, so we're working very, very closely with the Welsh Government around the letting of the next Wales and Borders franchise. We're hoping in August, when the specification for that franchise is announced, there will be a number of new services from Liverpool and the City Region into Cheshire and Wales, really to improve our connectivity in that area of accommodation and beyond. Obviously, as the Fire Authority also knows, there's lots of new opportunities for brand new fleet trains that we're buying for the Merseyrail network. One thing I did want to take the opportunity to update you on is only in the past couple of weeks we've signed the trial with staff of the manufacturer to actually have battery technology on those trains, which is a great opportunity for those trains to run beyond the Merseyrail network onto non-electrified lines. And there's a great opportunity to go to places like Headbolt Lane, Skelmersdale, like Wrexham, like Warrington, beyond Hunts Cross, for example. Obviously, to make all those new services work, we need to have better infrastructure and more resilient infrastructure. I'm really pleased to be stood here and saying that the Wirral slab track work, which was disruptive for the city region, actually was handled in the best possible way. And I'd like to thank all of our stakeholders for how that was managed, in not just the way the engineering was done so seamlessly and successfully and delivered on time, but actually how the contingency transport plans worked so well to keep the city region moving, and crucially the messaging made sure that whilst people knew it would take longer to get around, everyone knew that the city region was still open for business, so it worked really well. Learned a lot of lessons from that process, which is quite fortunate, because in the next few months we're going to be doing a similar process again when Lime Street has to close for 3 weeks in September. So again, the same processes are in place to ensure the engineering work is done properly. A very detailed, high-level transport plan is put in place to make sure that people can get in and around the city, particularly from a further distance, and crucially making sure that those media messages are also in play, so we get the right message that Liverpool and the city region remains fully open for business. All of that comes in a strategic approach. 3 years ago, and it seemed like a couple of weeks ago when you blink your eyes, we launched a long-term rail strategy for the city region's rail network. We always committed to constantly refreshing that to make sure it's contemporary and fit for our needs. The first refresh of that will be coming back to the Combined Authority in the autumn for your comments and endorsements to make sure that we've still got a very good strategic vision for our rail network going forward. Obviously, a number of the points I've just made link onto major transport schemes, and I'm really pleased to say that those that have been funded by the Growth Deal are on track. It's excellent that we're stuck here today to say that the work on the Holton Curve, as the name suggests, that curve piece of railway track in Holton, actually commenced today. We've been on site and we've seen that happen. Obviously, that means once that work is done in the middle of next year, we will have the potential to have direct trains from Liverpool going all the way out to North Wales, potentially even South Wales as well. So that's started and that's working well. The STEP programme is also being delivered, that's obviously another key project for us is around the Silver Jubilee Gateway Bridge. It's fantastic to see the progress with the brand new bridge. Obviously, to make sure that that works to its full potential, we've got to have the Silver Jubilee Bridge fully maintained to ensure that whole programme works in Holton and beyond. Obviously, there's a whole host of transport schemes in the SIF process, things including links to Parkside and Prescott, amongst others. That's going through the assessment process, and hopefully we'll be coming back to the team consideration in the coming months. That leads nicely on to strategic highways. Obviously, at the last meeting, you had a detailed update from Mick, where we are with the development of that key route network, so I won't repeat what he said. But obviously, to deliver that network, we do need to have additional funding for that. So there are a number of bits that we've put in, one with regard to the National Productivity Investment Fund for the Tower Road, but also the A57, and we're hoping to hear back on those bids shortly. And four other bids have been developed for a variety of schemes across the six districts with regard to the highway maintenance challenge. Finally, but by no means least, the bus services approach. Obviously, you've had a previous report on the success we've had so far with the Bus Alliance, that deep partnership of working with the bus operators that's actually seen almost 10% passenger growth on our bus network. That genuinely